to look over a very tall wall that has been built by the Israelis to divide the Palestinian people from each other. Families were divided because of the building of this tall wall. What is also interesting is that the Israelis have built a good motor road in Palestinian territory, but Palestinians were not allowed to use those motor roads. This is ridiculous. It has never happened to any other country. A foreign country builds a road in your country and you cannot use it. And then, of course, even though the UN resolution gave a part of Palestine to Israel to be called Israel, and the other part is to be Palestine, today we cannot recognize a Palestinian state. There is only a Palestinian authority. What has happened to the Palestinian state, which has actually been sanctioned by the United Nations? The United Nations itself has not exerted itself to ensure that Palestine remains as a state. This is a sad state of affairs in that part of the world. And of course, this morning you saw pictures of what happened when the Israelis invaded Gaza. The brutality of the Israelis is unprecedented. You see a man whose head has been blown off. He's dead, of course. He has his head blown off. Others lost their legs, lost their arms. This is perpetrated by Israel, purportedly in retaliation against these so-called rockets by Hamas. Now, Israel, with the agreement of the U.S., has an operation which is called Operation Justified Vengeance. Now, this is the first time that vengeance become a policy of a country. And this is Israel, that it seeks vengeance as a policy. And for them, vengeance means they had the right to invade and kill thousands of people in order to achieve vengeance against them. For whatever attack that may have been mounted by the Palestinian, nothing is comparable to the damage, the killings that was carried out by the Israelis. So we hope that the world will recognize Israel for what it is. It is a rogue state that obeys no international law. It is a state that should be brought to trial in a criminal court because it is indulging in killing people without cause, killing not soldiers, but ordinary civilians, non-combatants. So I would like to explain why we have been showing sympathy towards the Palestinian. It is really a question of humanitarian outlook. We see injustice, we see oppression, we see a lot of laws being broken, international as well as national. And if we do not respond to this, the governments will not respond to this also. Governments are not moved because they fear sanctions and trade being obstructed by certain powers. But governments always remember that it is the people who give them the power. If governments are pressured by the people, by a majority of the people anywhere, even in the United States, I am quite sure the governments will accede, will carry out the wishes of the people. I would like to appeal to all NGOs concerned with peace and justice, the NGOs who want to promote the rule of law, for them to take up this issue in their own country and to tell their governments that they will not accept a government that does not go against injustice. If their governments insist that they should support injustice, then it is up to the people via the NGOs to apply pressure on the governments. There are other things that can be done, but this particular session is about a call to action. It is no good just talking about these matters. We need to act. And in this session, we are going to talk about the need to act. The participants in this particular session, the speakers, are, if I may introduce them. On my right is Yang Amat Berbahagia Datin Paduka Sri Rosmah Mansor, wife of the Prime Minister of Malaysia. On my left is Her Excellency Ambassador Sarab Atay, Ambassador of Turkey to Malaysia. On the side, on the extreme right, is Mr. Dr. M.S. Dolatabadi, Deputy Head of Mission Embassy of Iran. And finally, on my extreme left is His Excellency Dr. Ahmad Salem Saleh Al-Wahisi, Chief Representative of the League of Arab States Mission, New Delhi. Following their presentation, we will allow for question and answers from the questions from the floor. In order to expedite things, I would like to ask you to write down your questions. There will be people going around distributing papers so that you can write down your questions, and then I will put the questions to the relevant speaker. So please write down the speaker and also the question. If we have time, we might even ask speakers from the floor to ask the questions verbally. But I would prefer if the questions are in written form. So, ladies and gentlemen, I would like now to give the floor to Yang Amat Berbahagia Datin Paduka Sri Rosmah Mansor. We can hear or there? Sorry.
Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Yang Amat Berbahagia Tun Dr. Mahathir bin Mohamad, Chairman of Perdana Global Peace Organization. Yang Amat Berbahagia Tun Dr. Siti Hasmah Muhammad Ali. Honorable Speakers, Excellencies, Distinguished Guests, Friends, Members of the Media, Ladies and Gentlemen. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi taala wabarakatuh. A very good afternoon to all of you. First and foremost, I would like to thank the organizer.